Well, millions watched as German Chancellor Angela Merkel and her Social Democratic opponent, Peer Steinbrück, faced off in their first and only debate ahead of the election. The 90-minute primetime debate may have been Steinbrück's last attempt to cut Merkel's big lead. Germany's financial health and the Eurozone debt crisis were among the topics discussed. The Chancellor is looking for a third term. Voters head to the polls in 3 weeks' time. CNN's Diana Magnay is joining us now live from our Berlin bureau with more on the debate. So, Diana, who won?
Well, Ralitza, this wasn't really a debate that, however many millions may have watched it, that set the nation's television screens on fire. Angela Merkel was sort of more conciliatory, really, than she was combative. And in fact, if you look at the polls from the two of the four broadcasters who aired this debate, they don't even agree on who won. One of them says that Steinbrück won marginally over Angela Merkel because he was more powerful in his arguments, and the other broadcaster has it the other way around. In fact, Spiegel, one of the big sort of online websites and magazines in this country, drew a nil-nil, zero for both of them, really because of the sort of lack of flamboyance of the whole 90-minute event. Peer Steinbrück, who is the head of the opposition Social Democrats, he really tried to differentiate himself because he says he's campaigning on a platform of social justice, criticizing the ruling coalition for their sort of policy of vacillation, as he called it, over the last few years. He had the first word in this debate. Let's just take a listen to a part of what he said.
There needs to be a government which is led and which does not go around in circles like the last 4 years, without a direction or guideline, but one that acts and does not just waltzing from summit to another. I would like to do this differently.
Angela Merkel's line is very much, you know, look how good we have it at the moment. You're in a safe pair of hands. We have more work to do, but Germany is doing well right now. The economic situation is good. The people are content. Unemployment is low. So if you vote for us, we will continue to serve your interests. And according to the latest opinion polls, you know, that's what many people believe Angela Merkel is, a safe pair of hands. Let's listen to what she had to say as to why people should vote for her.
We can simply tell the people in this country that we can achieve further progress. The work is, of course, not over yet. Of course, there are many worries, many woes, but we have shown that we can do it. And that in a difficult time, in a time during which we had the worst European crisis, that Germany is strong, Germany is a growth motor, Germany is an anchor for stability, and I want to continue on this path. And I think that what we have to show really convinces people.
The trouble is, Ralitza, that there isn't really much in policy terms to choose between the two candidates. On Europe, for example, most Germans, according to opinion polls, say they're fairly content with the way that the Chancellor has tried to preserve their interests over the period of this euro crisis. And in fact, Peer Steinbrück was her finance minister for 4 of the 8 years that she's been in power. And the SPD has always backed her proposals for Greek bailouts and help for the rest of the Eurozone. So really, whether there would be a much of a shift in policy is sort of up in the air in terms of Europe. They both agree that Germany should not be drawn into any kind of military intervention in Syria. There was a bit of discussion about whether Angela Merkel should have been more forceful on, for example, the NSA data affair. But really, this is a sort of question of personality over politics. And Peer Steinbrück has got a long way to go in the polls if he's to catch up with Angela Merkel, Ralitza.
Diana, thank you very much.